Well, it was in Victorian England. These views of contemporary idyllic life were so popular with the new moneyed classes. Do you have English connections?
Well, my husband has, but...
Has he?
Yes.
And did he buy the picture because...
We bought it in Malta, though, not because... Yeah.
Because you loved it, rather than...
Yes, we fell in love with it when we saw it, yes, immediately. Both of us liked it very much.
Because I think they're wonderful, aren't they? I mean, it's wonderful to see the everyday objects of a Victorian peasant home, I suppose one could say, although they're looking... She's looking reasonably well off. The little child asleep, the discarded trumpet.
Yes.
In fact, maybe it's, we don't know whether it's a little girl or a little boy because there's a doll in the corner. And always Carlton Smith, who is the artist, Carlton Alfred Smith, always has this rather delicate touch. It's the cat, really, which is also so beautifully painted by the fire, snoozing by the fire, which makes it so nice. This, in fact, was painted when he was 33. And he'd studied in London, was a London artist. Although these sort of paintings weren't just bought by the London gentry, they were very much bought by the new industrialists in Birmingham and Liverpool. And really, to see this sort of painting in England, you really, the best place is to go to those northern museums.
I see.
But you've had it for a long time?
Some 20 years.
For 20 years?
Yes.
Yes, and you still look at it every day?
Oh, yes, it's my favourite.
Good. Well, in fact, this sort of beautiful picture has gone into fashion in the mid-70s, very much in fashion. In the early 80s, has dropped out of fashion a little bit because of the taste now is for impressionist and post-impressionist. And now, once again, they're coming back. Although a picture as pretty and as beautifully painted as this has never really dropped very much in price. I think if we're talking in British pounds, it would be worth between £7,000 and £10,000, British pounds.
I see. It's more than we thought.
This quite extraordinary, remarkable object is a pilgrim bottle. And I think they're called pilgrim bottles because they originally derived from a 12th century sheepskin thing of roughly this shape. Now, they became very popular in silver at the end of the 17th century, and they were made in this sort of size and quality for a period of about 20 years, and then they stopped making them again until they reintroduced them in the 19th century. And this particular one was given for the Queen's Prize at Ascot. And it has here the Royal Coat of Arms, the gift of Her Majesty the Queen, Ascot 1874. And in a moment we'll turn it round and we'll have a look at the hallmark, which is very clear on it. Quite a remarkable thing. Sort of laid on strap work, really beautiful. I'm now going to turn it round sideways because I'd like to show these beautiful masks which are hidden under the chain. There they are, beautifully modelled, really quite amazing. And there's the hallmark. It was made by Garrards, who were the Royal Silversmiths then and still are. The maker's mark, date, letter, standard marks and the duty mark. Quite an extraordinary thing. How did it actually come into your family?
Well, it used to belong to my aunt.
Yes.
And I've inherited from her.
She didn't win it at Ascot?
No, I don't think so.
Right.
This came with the cup.
Well, this is quite an interesting letter, dated 1956. And they say, probably in a sale room, it would fetch 6 or 7 shillings an ounce, which for 341 ounces would fetch between 100 and 120 pounds. Well, the price of silver is now about £3 an ounce, so do you think this would probably be worth about 600 or 700 pounds today? Something like that? Well, would it surprise you to know that this quite remarkable object today would probably fetch something between 30,000 and 40,000 pounds sterling.